Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at some of the new features in Numbers 6.1. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So Numbers version 6.1 has some of the same improvements that Pages and Keynote have just gotten. And those are to have images embedded inside of text in line. So this image here, for instance, I pasted into this text here and I can move it around like it's a character in the text. Also, text fills now can have gradients in them and advanced gradients and images, and you can also do outlines on text. So doing fancy titles is possible now in Numbers as well. And another new feature is when you have a shape, say a circle like this, and you drag an image into it, it's going to center immediately on the face that's found there in the shape. Of course, you can adjust it afterwards, but at least it's going to jump immediately to that face. So those things probably marginally useful here in Numbers, more useful in Pages and Keynote, but we get them as part of an update to all three apps. Much more useful are the changes specifically for Numbers. So one of those is what happens when you try to enter new rows in a filtered table. So for instance, you have a table like this where you have products over here and other information about them in the table. And let's say you go to filter this table. So I'm going to go to Organize, Filter, and I'm going to add a filter for the product column. And I'm going to say that the text is, and I'm going to set it to apples. And watch what will happen, of course, is we only now see the rows that have apples in them. So row 2, 5, 6, 8, 12, 13, 16. Now in the past, when you do this, you can't enter data into the table. In order to enter data, you've got to turn the filter off, and now you can enter new data and then you turn it back on to get the filtered view. But now in Numbers 6.1, you can add a new row. And not only can you add it, it'll assume that the filter column gets the proper value here. So since we filtered on apples, we're going to get apples here. Otherwise, this row wouldn't even be visible. So I can continue to enter in apples information here, and the next one will do it as well. And if I were to switch to another thing for the filter, then adding a new row would automatically add that one. Now another feature is the ability to link inside of the document to a different sheet. So it's important to note this only works inside the same document, and all you can do is link to a different sheet. So an example of a use for this would be here. I have a column marked overhead, and the formula here is looking something up in a table. It's looking it up in this table, which is in sheet 2. So a nice thing to be able to do, especially if I'm thinking years in advance with this sheet and I want to quickly be able to get to whatever this is linking to, I can select the text here, go format, and there's add link as before, but in addition to web page and email, I can now say sheet, and I can say I want it to link to this particular sheet. So now when I click here, it jumps right to this sheet here. So this is a simple example, but you can imagine a very complex document with a whole bunch of different sheets and a whole bunch of different calculations, and having these links be very useful to be able to get around and figure out what's happening inside of a spreadsheet. Now another thing that's changed is the precision of calculations. It's hard to show this, of course, because we're only going to see the current precision, but Apple has this document here that explains, you know, basically in the previous version you would get a number like this if you subtracted 9.8 from 10.0, but now with the new version it's got greater precision, so you actually get 0.2 followed by lots of zeros. And it gives some examples here and explains how a binary is used to represent floating point values like ones with lots of decimal places. It's great to see Apple working so hard to improve these Office apps. We only got version 6.0 at the end of March, and in June we got this version 6.1. Last year we got versions 5.0, 5.1, 5.2, and 5.3, each one adding some new things. And I bet we can look forward to some more updates this year and whole new versions coming out pretty much every year like clockwork. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.